everybody, it's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com, and today we're going to be learning about how we store garlic. Now, we have done an experiment, some of you may know, about what to do with garlic when you want to plant it. It's planted in October here in Wisconsin, and this year we decided that we were going to do an experiment with inoculated garlic and regular, just put it in the earth garlic. And what we did was take exactly the same garlic from the same source, and for the inoculated batch, we took the cloves apart and we soaked them overnight in a mixture of fish emulsion and water. They sat overnight. The next morning, we drained them, and then we put them into 100 proof vodka. Yes, they got to swim in vodka for about 15, 20 minutes, and then we immediately planted them. The other ones, the normal ones, the way we usually do it, by just putting them into the ground, we did nothing. We just took them apart and we put them into the ground as we normally do. This is the result: inoculated, not inoculated. Now that they've been sitting, well, we dug them up and they've been sitting out here on our deck for about 2 weeks, maybe a little more. They're pretty much dried out right now. When we brought them out here, the paper had not yet formed on here. Paper is just the outside skin of the garlic, and what you want to do is make sure that that is nice and dry, okay? Because it rains here, sometimes we had to put plastic over them just to keep them dry, and it worked nicely. The bottom is open, so even if it rained on them, which it did once or twice, I mean, the water just goes right through. So now we're ready to store it. We need to have it in an airy bag or lying out someplace. And if you let it dry long enough, and if you store them hanging in a bag or in a dry place, they should last pretty much all winter. And that's why the kind we use is a German purple striped hard neck garlic, not the soft neck, the hard neck. And that's, well,
there's
because,
a reason for that too,
right? The hard neck garlic lasts longer in this climate. I mean, it'll store better for a longer period of time. Soft neck is a little bit more aromatic, but it won't last as long if you're storing it for the winter.
And if this is the first time somebody's watching one of your videos on garlic, you have several other videos they can go back to see how you plant it, how you inoculate, why you inoculate,
right,
and why you put it in vodka, because those are very important reasons.
Right. I can just tell you that from now on we'll be inoculating.
Yes.
Now that they are dried out, and you can see they're dry as can be, the roots are dry, the stalk is dry, now we can trim them so that they look like what you might buy in a grocery store. And that's another thing. Do not plant the kind that you buy in a grocery store. Be sure to go to a garden center or order them online. And what you want is more like a seed garlic, a garlic grown especially for planting.
Specifically?
Yes, thank you, that too. And then you're gonna chop off the top. And you can see the purple in there. And then you're going to chop off the roots. Make it look real pretty.
They pretty garlic, huh?
Nice gifts. And then you're going to take an old fruit bag or vegetable bag, onion bag, and just pop them in there. And then we hang ours in the basement for the winter.
Ah, the aroma of going into the basement, fresh garlic.
Well, we got in a little bit of a rush because we had some visitors stop by, and in the meanwhile it decided it was going to start sprinkling out, so we're kind of in a rush to get these inside before the rain gets them all wet again. And that's where we'll trim off these roots and make them clean. Now these are the large inoculated ones.
So these are going to use for seed stock. You'll select the largest ones and
Yes. Use
some of these for seed stock
right. This
year. That's a nice thing about buying authentic garlic. As you grow it, you get to select and keep the biggest ones for the following fall to
Yes. Plant
again.
Exactly. And then your stock just builds up and builds up. Now, don't get sideswiped in the grocery store thinking that those, what they call elephant garlic, which is large, it looks like this, maybe even bigger, that's really not a garlic. It's really an onion.
Are they milder?
They are milder, right, and they don't store as well. So what you want to do is, like I said, go to your garden center or online and order garlic for planting. And you're going to do it in the fall if you live in the Northern Hemisphere. October is when we put ours in. Now that the fun of chopping off the tops and the bottoms are done, I've put them into the net bags. And for a couple of weeks, we will hang them out here just to finish curing. And then eventually we will give some away and we will store the rest in the basement where it's cool.
Now, do you have a specific number you put in each bag, or doesn't it matter?
I just eyeballed it.
Because you don't want to cram it, I mean.
No, you want it to be able to breathe through the bag. So I didn't stuff the bags full. I just
Okay. Let
them, they approximately have about the same amount.
And then you're going to hang them here in the screen porch for a couple of weeks, or?
Yeah. A couple of weeks,
give them
Yet. Thoroughly
a chance to dry.
Yes.
And then we're going to take that fragrance down to our lower basement.
Well, there's no way we're going to eat all this garlic. I haven't even done the inoculated batch yet.
Huh?
So we'll be giving it away. We have a food pantry that we like to share things with, and we have neighbors, and I'm sure we'll find a home for them.
Okay, and then you're going to keep your largest ones for the seed stock, right?
Well, if we want. If we want to plant this again, maybe just as a comparison again next year. These are the uninoculated ones. This little pile over here, I sorted out because a lot of these didn't have enough paper on them to keep them. Yeah, they had either split open for whatever reason or we gouged them with a fork. So these I'll be using now so that they don't get spoiled, and I'm sure we'll be free from werewolves and Dracula for a long, long time.
That's a fringe benefit of growing garlic.
Exactly. Since we started this project earlier this morning, it's now mid-afternoon. We've had several visitors come through. We've had a temperature change. Rick's got the car wheels rotated. I mean, it's been a busy day. So we are finally ready to get everything packed away. This is the last of the inoculated garlics for storage. And I've marked the bags with a piece of green twisty tie so we know which is which and we don't get them confused. These will be our seed garlics. These are the largest ones. These we'll use for planting in October, possibly for sharing with other people as seed garlics. Then these are ones that there's nothing wrong with them, but because they don't have enough paper on them, and they're kind of splitting open, it means that they would not last the whole season being stored. So these will need to be eaten first, which is fine. All right, so these guys are going in the bag. The bag's marked, so we know that this is the inoculated ones.
Well, and that this is our seed crop for fall.
Right. I don't want to crowd them, so I'm going to put them in two bags. And then we'll just hang those like the other ones until we're ready to plant them. Then the other ones that we are not planting will be going downstairs where it's cooler and dry.
If we still have some.
If we still have some.
Hey, it has been an amazing day today. We've taken 3 garden tours, basically, and unexpected, but that's fun, you know.
Yes,
and the free book library, and
yes,
that was interesting, having all the little kids over this morning.
Yes, it was. Eating their way through the garden was great. And we found a hornworm, our first hornworm that we ever saw.
Before we end this video, let's take everybody out to the front porch and actually show them this hornworm that we found. This is the first one we've ever found in 40 years, over 40 years of gardening.
Right. I think it's just the weather, the way the weather's been.
Yeah, pretty amazing,
and things that we've learned since we found the hornworm about what's happening to it.
Yeah. Well, when you get that one, let's go to the front porch.
Okay. As we were picking tomatoes this morning, I saw what I thought was a weed that had gone to seed, and I pulled it out only to realize that it was a green hornworm, tomato hornworm. And you can see all of the white things on there. That's what I thought was part of the flower, or maybe the seeds of a flower. And then I realized that's not what it was at all. You can see the horn part of the worm right here. Now, hornworms can get 4 inches long, so this is actually quite a small one. And then when we did some research online, we realized that those white things that are on the hornworm are actually the
wasp eggs.
Wasp eggs of a small wasp that attacks hornworms and lays its eggs on the hornworm, and then the wasp babies will eventually pretty much kill the hornworm. So when we looked at it, it said if you find one in your garden and it's got these little eggs all over it, leave it there because it's keeping the hornworm population down in your garden. Who knew?
No. That was pretty amazing, because when I first saw it, I thought that was some kind of flowering weed. And then as I looked at it closer, I said, those sure look like eggs. And again, doing a little research, sure enough. And then we have a monarch butterfly, which is...
Well, we have the caterpillar.
Caterpillar, rather, which is just about to go into its chrysalis. And we had another one that actually went into a chrysalis. So it's going to be fun watching those as well. And then we'll probably put this one back out into
the garden,
because those wasps then will do something very special in the future.
Right, because then they'll stick around in the garden, and if another hornworm shows up, these wasps will lay its eggs on that one. So it's a preventative and kind of a fixative right away in one. If you enjoyed this video and found it informative, please give us a thumbs up. We really appreciate when you're watching and you make sure that other people know that it's worthwhile to watch. We love to hear your comments and questions. And if you'd like to become part of our garden family, just hit this little subscribe button. Thank you so much. Enjoy your weekend, and keep your eyes open in your garden.
No, you never know what you're going to find. Kind of like a box of chocolate, too, isn't it?
Your little caterpillar is moving around here now.
Is he? Well,
yes,
finally.
He is.
Maybe he's getting out of his J stage and ready to actually go into a pupa.
Yep.
So we'll keep an eye on him as well.
Connect with us on YouTube.